Gershwin WoodCraft. Today we're going to use a lathe to make one of these, your own yo-yo. I start with 3-inch blocks of wood, my pen mandrel, my bushings for a slimline pen, a 1/4-inch shaft. You can get a dowel. I like to use these plastic ones that I get at the hobby shop. I find that they're smoother. They provide a better axle. And little plugs for the holes. And you put all those together and you're going to have one of these. Now in today's demonstration, I'm going to be using this setup where I cut 30-degree triangles, married them together to make a slightly more interesting design. Thought it'd be more fun to watch this get made. On this sample piece, I'll first cut a small hole for the plug, which I will then follow up with a full bore with a 1/4-inch drill bit so it'll fit through the mandrel. So I'll start with something wider to give me some room there. I butt this one up to that. I put that in. I put that on. And now, I'm ready to make a yo-yo. Okay, now that we've reduced it, and as I showed you, I kept them butt together so that they're absolutely the same width. Now that I'm ready to start designing the profile of the yo-yo, I've added a spacer in the middle so I can work on all sides at the same time. And I want to just make sure that both sides are the same. If the yo-yo is not balanced, it will not roll, it will not yo-yo well. So, first thing we want to do is decide how much of a butterfly we want. So now I'm going to measure it in. I'm going to measure the same amount in on this side as this side, which then I use this to mark it. I'm going to measure here. I'm going to do the same thing here. More than just a design element, this channel is going to allow me to adjust the weight of the yo-yo later when we have to balance it. If you want your yo-yo to truly work supremely, both sides have to have the same weight. At which point I take out my gram scale and I will quickly weigh the two of them. It takes a few rounds of adjustments to the depth of the channel in order to get both sides perfectly balanced to each other. But now comes the boring part. Now we have to sand them and get them ready for polishing. I won't bore you with that part. So now we've sanded it and we're ready to rock. Now, unlike pens and bowls, which I would sand up to maybe 12,000 grit, this is a toy. This is a yo-yo. It's going to be banging into the ground. There's no point in getting crazy. So I bring it up to 400 grit. For today's demonstration, we're just going to go with the good old-fashioned friction polish. So we put it on. We We get it all soak into the wood, and you'll see the whole wood comes to life. Now we have a yo-yo ready to be axled.
Now comes the trickiest part of the whole yo-yo, getting the gap between the two sides just right. If it's too tight, it won't go down, and if it's too loose, it won't come back up. I came up with one method that seems to work well. I made one yo-yo that worked, and I measured it, the gap, with playing cards. As long as I use the same amount of cards, my gap is always consistent and the yo-yo seems to work just fine.
Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 playing cards. So we get the axle on one, put the yo-yo string over, put the axle on the other side. And, remember as I said, 10 cards. Alright.
After a few test throws and adjustments, you can cut off the excess axle, a few drops of CA glue, and you're done.
Well, I'm pretty happy with the way the yo-yo came out. It's a perfect weight, not too heavy, doesn't hurt when it whips back up into my hand. I hope you enjoyed spending some time in my shop learning about it. Please go to GershwinWoodCraft.com to see my complete gallery, other projects, segmented bowls, pens, candle holders. I look forward to making more YouTube videos, and I hope you'll join me for them. Thank you.